So I want to do a quick topic on using the MACD to detect if the market is going to go up or down. So in a very simple level, so this is the MACD. I use many different indicators, but the MACD is one of the more trusted ones. So in general, what you do, if the MACD is positive above zero, the market is going to go up. And in general, if the market is below zero, if the MACD is below zero, the market is going to go down. That's what the MACD typically does. So the trend is generally up. So for right here, so let's give a quick example here. So there's basically a signal line and a MACD line. The signal line is the red line and the MACD line is the white line. So some people also argue that the market is going to go down when the signal line crosses, it, depending on if the signal line is above or below the MACD. So in this particular instance, a lot of people would argue that the market is going to go down. But as you can see, the market did not go down. It just went down a little bit and then continued going up. So it just shows that basically the market is slowing down in the upward position. So typically what you do, there's two ways to trade. You can do when the line crosses, or you can also do when the line crosses zero line. Now that is all configured by how you have your MACD set up. So you can do a fast period, a slow period, and a signal period. And you can specify whatever you want. And basically the way that I do this is I say, am I interested in looking back 16 periods and comparing that to 8 periods. So I compare that, and that's how I basically think of when I use my MACD. So in general, there are a lot of little details when thinking about the MACD, but please keep in mind that you want to make sure that you don't forget the simple truth that when it's above zero, that's a positive trend, and when it's below zero, that's a negative trend. So the other interesting thing you can do with the MACD is when it's in general above zero and going up and down, you can say that that's in general an uptrend. So here you see some ups and downs, but in general it's an uptrend because it's staying above zero. Now here you can start to see it goes below zero and that's a downtrend, and then it's definitely a downtrend here you can see. Now, when it turns around, typically what you can do, even on an uptrend, you can do these little lines here, and these are levels of support and resistance. So right here, this is level of resistance, and this is level of resistance. You can see these are peaks that commonly turned around. So even though you are in an uptrend, you can still have these levels of resistance, and you can see that all throughout here, right at that point, you saw the it started to go up and then it started to hit a resistance and went down a little bit. So that was definitely true here. You can see that, and you can also see now that it kind of went through a phase of not exactly straight up like it did go through right there. The other interesting thing you can do on the MACD is you can look at the slope. So basically these slopes of these lines give you some idea of what is happening, right? So when it's going down, typically that's slowing down. It still is in a positive territory here. But sometimes if the slope is steep enough, it can be a downtrend. So right here, this slope happened to be steep enough. So anything around that steepness will be a downtrend. So you can see you do have some downtrends even on these positive sides. So let me clear up some of these diagrams so we can kind of get back to square one and you can see what's going on. So in general, this MACD is running over many days. So you can see the cycle of the chart here. You have a lot of volume and then no volume at nighttime, a lot of volume, no volume at nighttime. So basically the MACD will keep track of everything even in the nighttime time. So even at nighttime, you can see this is a nighttime here and it didn't stay relatively flat. Now what happens in the MACD is it typically goes back to zero because it's staying relatively flat. So to follow the trend, we know that it's basically in a positive trend here, but there is a signal line over here. So in this particular instance, we have a signal line that is above it, so that shows that it is kind of going down. So it's in a positive trend still, but it is kind of fading on that positive trend. And we don't have much to go left before it's actually considered a negative trend. So that's kind of the state here. So what you can do is you can switch time frames, and then you can start to see what's been going on in the time frame below it. And that gives you more detail for the trend. So let's just switch back and forth between the lower higher time frame. So this little instance here, you can see that in general that was highly up, but on the lower time frame, you see there's actually some instances where it says it's downward trend. Now, you can say there's two general approaches to say downward trend. Again, it's not necessarily considered a downward trend, but if the MACD is going down like this, that does mean downward trend. Especially if it crosses the signal line, you'll see that as a downward trend signal. But there are parts of this that you see up. Now, you have to go to a lower time frame to really see the details of the MACD. So, again, when I first started using the MACD, I thought, well, if it's going down, then it means down. But it definitely does not always mean that. So, basically, it depends on the slope of the down and how steep that is. Now, as you zoom in here, you can kind of see that this is not really as steep as this part. And this is more steep, and you can see that the downward trend is actually showing up there. So, again, this is primarily an upward trend, and you can see that most of the day it is upward trend. So typically after a big jump like this, you will see a continuation on the positive side. So let's just kind of test this theory here above and below, right? So this is definitely below, and you can see that's definitely a downward trend here. Now this is kind of a mix. We have an upward side positive and a negative, and you have a negative right in around in here. So now technically, when I look at these negative determinations, this is a pretty good example. The negative probably started back in here, right? You can see on the MACD, if we zoom in here, it actually started to slow down right there. Now, the signal line crossed right here, and then that was where it actually started to be negative. Now, it depends on the slope, right? So this slope is kind of gradual, so it's actually just leveling off at a positive rate. So right there is where it actually started to be negative. Now, you could also say right there, it takes a couple candle wicks to really start to get the MACD to go, because the MACD is a lagging indicator. So it is a good idea to look at the signal line. If it crosses here, it did cross, you can kind of do shorts there if you'd like. So that's one way to do it. However, some people like to wait until the MACD line itself crosses. Now, all the signal line is a moving average. So it's just a moving average of this line, of the white line. So whenever it changes above or below the moving average, you can see that. So to answer the question of, is it going up or is it going down? You have to look at a couple factors, right? So basically what you do is you can say, is the MACD above? So MACD is above in this instance, so it is still in the positive territory. Now the second instance is to look at the signal line. Now if the signal line is crossed, that's another way to say that, well, maybe it's on a downtrend. So when the signal line is above here. Now you can also say on the MACD, there's the internal histogram. Now the histogram basically gives you a measurement of the distance between the MACD line and the signal line. Now when that's getting larger, that's always a sign that you have a positive change. Now when it's getting smaller, that's typically a sign that you have a negative change, right? So these are all negative moves here, and you can see the candles are pretty much aligned up with the positive and negative moves on the actual price chart. So how to use the MACD on the lowest time frame. So the lowest time frame, typically what you would want to do is use this for your entries and exits. So here we know that the entry would have to be a, because it's below the zero, it would have to be a short. So MACD is saying that it's below this line. Now you can see also that the signal line is converging. So this is so close to the zero line that we don't really know for certain if it's a short. So it's not a super big short, but you can say in general, it's probably a short entry. Now, the other thing that you want to do before you enter the trade as a short is you want to look at the higher time frame and see what's going on in the MACD. Now, you can see that also it's been quite high here, and it's actually going down to the negative side as well. Now, you might say if you go one more time frame, it's actually on the positive side. So within the 15-minute interval, so you probably can't hold your trade for longer than maybe 15 minutes. Now, you want to say that you could probably hold this trade. Now, if you draw a line and you measure this on this chart, this from here to here is about 9 bars. So that's 9 times 15. So that is quite some time. You can probably measure it on the hour chart and say how far, how many hours are you from the zero line. So you're still, if this is going down, we got at least 12 bars. So we got at least 12 hours here that we could stay in the positive territory. So even though this chart says that it's gonna start to be a short, that is still considered an upward trend on the other higher timeframes. So this is where the MACD gets a little bit confusing, and you need to look at multiple timeframes to make the best choice. Now, I will try to do some live trading and some live during the daytime estimates for this. One of the problems is that this always hangs near zero near the end of the day because this is outside, this is extended hours, and there's very little volume and very little trading done. So typically the price will stay pretty level and the MACD will always move back to zero right at the start of the day. You can see right at the start of the day, it pretty much stayed close to zero. And at the end of the day, it will stay close to zero. So it is most interesting to look at the MACD during the middle of the day because that's where most of the volume is and that's where most of the big price moves are. So let's look at this day as an example of where the MACD would say to buy and sell. So here's an example right at the start of the day. So basically you have 9 o'clock, you can see the volume is very low, and then right at 9:30, the volume is high. So the MACD is saying sell, 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 sell all the way down. And then there's a little instance where this MACD line goes above the signal line where it's actually a buy signal, right, within the downtrend. So if you are considering doing a buy, you know it's gonna be a very short buy, or possibly unless it, especially if it doesn't hold the signal line here. So you wanna be very cautious because you are pretty low on the MACD line here. Now, the other thing you know about the MACD is that once it gets to the maximums here on these, this is a level, this becomes a level of support because basically the MACD never gets to be that low. And once it gets to be that low, you basically have a reversal case. So even though it is a downtrend, you start to say you're gonna have to have an uptrend at some point right around in here. And indeed, we do see a reversal. We see first a sign of a possible reversal right here, but then it kept going down. Now the reversal definitely started right in here. And you can see the signal line crossed, the MACD line crossed, and it went up. And you can see that it quite went up. Now, if this slope was any less, if the slope was like here, you'd see a more of a flattening out of this. It wouldn't necessarily be up. It could even be a sideways trend, depending on the slope. And that's what you want to look for, basically, is the slope lines. Now let's look at this trade really carefully here, right? So what happened is that there's actually, this is just a couple minutes, so this is a very fast time frame. And you can see that the reversal here kind of started with this candle, and you can see if you look carefully at the candle, there was some positive side of that candle as well as the negative side. So the candle did hint that there was going to be some positive change, and you can see even these candles were starting to hint at the positive reversal. So we knew that coming from the candle side of things that there was going to possibly be a reversal. Now, sometimes it's hard to see that with the MACD. You can see that the MACD kind of had this little bit of flattening here. And you can see these green candles. So what you can typically do is that if you start to see green candles within the downward trend, so if this was all green and there was one red candle in here, I would say that that would be a sign of reversal. Now, because we didn't have that, this is the first sign of reversal, it's probably going to be a sharper reversal. And we didn't see any green within that. Now we saw one green here that shows a sign of a possible reversal as well. And we can see that it kind of hugs right around here. So my basic point is there are many ways to tell whether the trend is positive or negative. And you want to use all of them to kind of study what's been going on. Now I actually really like using the candlesticks in the middle here to tell me what the trend is. So you can see that this is still positive because all this is positive here. Now, it didn't quite get it to be negative until this trend started right here. So all of this is considered possibly a downtrend because the bar chart is converging here and you start to see some negativity on the downward side. So let's look at this side really carefully so we can see what happened here, right? So what is the trend? The trend is in general a positive trend because we've had all this positivity right here. So the MACD started to turn around and that's because the signal line crossed. So we can say that this is maybe gonna be a negative trend now. And we can see that that probably started back here at this candle, right? Because we see some red here on that, and that means that this is converging and getting closer and tighter So the technical trend maybe started back here, but we still could play this as a positive trend until the actual signal line crosses. And at that point, we still don't know that it's going to be a positive or negative trend. We still would say it could be either one. But it's going to be a negative trend here because we have a pretty steep slope down. So anyway, I just wanted to try to finish up here and say that, you know, the higher time frames in general give you the idea of the direction. So if you're looking for the direction for the day, look at the day chart. If you're looking for 60 minutes or 15 minutes, look at the 15 minute chart or 60 minute chart. So, but in general, the higher the time frame, the more you're going to have certainty that that's the direction of what's happening. So, because this is positive, you can see that this is a positive trend, and all the lower time frames should be positive as well. Now, when you see a divergence between them, you just have to be wary that maybe for the day, things might change. Anyway, so I hope this has helped you understand how the MACD works.